This entitled parent is about to let their child go wild, and nothing can stop them. How will all these shoppers survive the wrath of this crazy family? Happy birthday if today's your birthday, and on with the revamped show. Last summer, I was at a cousin's wedding. His bride and her family had been close with ours since before I was born, and the couple had known each other since they were toddlers. So it was a particularly exciting event for both sides of the family. However, after the ceremony was over and the party had only just started, one of the bridesmaids decided to announce her own engagement. The attention was immediately taken away from the newlyweds and brought to the bridesmaid, who I'll call Sarah, and her equally smug fiancé. My cousin's wife, I'll call her Emma, didn't make a scene or utter a single negative word about Sarah. She looked like she was on the verge of tears, but she kept grinning and acted very happy for the other couple. This was unusual, as Emma is typically quite confrontational and speaks her mind no matter the consequences. Sarah later picked Emma to be the maid of honor at her own wedding, which took place last weekend. I wasn't there for it, but my cousin sent me some of the best bits on Snapchat and explained the whole situation. This is where the fun begins. Emma's two much younger sisters were the flower girls at Sarah's wedding. At the very last moment, Emma switched out the white petals in their baskets to blue ones she had secretly brought with her. She told her sisters not to say anything about it, or let the bride see them until it was time to scatter them down the aisle. Sarah looked very confused upon seeing the blue petals, which didn't coordinate whatsoever with her theme. But of course, she didn't say anything about it in the moment. Most of Sarah's other bridesmaids were also Emma's friends, had attended Emma's wedding, and were in on Emma's scheme. At the reception, Emma's sisters and the other bridesmaids were tight-lipped when Sarah began demanding to know why there were blue petals. The wedding planner ended up getting a lot of abuse for not checking the flower girls' baskets before they walked down the aisle. Finally, it was time for the speeches. The speeches took place in front of a massive screen, displaying a loop of photos with Sarah and her husband, which had been compiled by Emma. Emma took the remote that controlled the presentation screen, and at first, she showed some pre-approved humorous photos of Sarah with Emma and other friends to facilitate a couple lighthearted jokes. Then, at the very end, Emma said to Sarah that she must be wondering why there were blue petals instead of the white ones originally planned. That is when Emma displayed the last slide from her presentation. Emma announced in front of everyone that she was 5 months pregnant and that she'd just discovered the baby was a boy, hence the blue petals. The last slide, her ultrasound picture. There were shocked yells and gasps. Sarah had a fit, but those involved in the scheme cheered so loudly that I sincerely regret watching the Snapchat recording with headphones. Apparently, Sarah had been very nasty to her bridesmaids before, driving several of them away and forcing the others to pay ridiculous amounts of money for dresses. Emma and my cousin were eventually thrown out of the party, but they were all smiles. Sarah's fuming mother went to confront her outside, and Emma retorted with, "Gentle, gentle, I'm pregnant." I reckon Sarah doesn't speak to the majority of those bridesmaids anymore. If Sarah was a good friend that just made a mistake, when Emma pulled off the whole announcing pregnancy at the wedding, if she had any sense of self-awareness, she would have realized, oh wait, that's what I did at her wedding, and she's just getting me back. And she could have actually redeemed the whole situation by having a good laugh about it, and be like, wow, you actually got me really good. I'm really sorry that this is how you felt when I did this at your wedding. The fact that she's completely oblivious, she's now somehow the victim, even though that's exactly what she did. Except this is in retaliation. She was the one who did it first. The revenge was so beautifully done as well. Like, it seems like such a minor thing, changing the white petals for blue. It's kind of strange, it's just a little bit off. Until the big reveal with the slideshow. Not only revealing the big mystery of why the petals were blue, but at the same time getting her revenge against Sarah. They said they originally posted this in petty revenge, but what I think they meant to say was, it was originally posted in petal revenge. Could be like its own new subreddit. Very niche though, very niche. All forms of revenge involving only petals. About 10 years ago, my parents decided to rent their shack, summer home, out to long-term tenants as we weren't using it much. It was a nice house, and they'd put a lot of effort and time into making it as good as their main home. Backstory. The area was nice with a mix of shackies and permanent residents. We had water views, a short walk to the beach, and about an hour's drive to the CBD. The family they got in seemed okay. The dad had a job, and the mum was on DSP as their circa 7-year-old daughter was mentally disabled. After about 6 months, they started getting behind, paying rent late, and were letting the place get all tatty. My mum wasn't impressed, and she is very house proud. In this state, if a tenant is late, you can give them a notice to vacate, but if they bring the rent up to date within 14 days, the notice is void. It's an important step because after issuing 3 notices, you can evict the tenants. Anyway, I was tasked with driving the hour trip to issue the first notice. I did it as I had the time, and I wanted to also let them know that it wasn't an eviction notice, and to explain that it was null and void so long as they paid their rent. I get to the property and see what Mum had mentioned about the property being tatty. See their mastiff dog tearing around the yard, with their kids' toys and crap everywhere. I start thinking that this isn't a nice family, this is gutter trash. I go through the gate, ignoring the mastiff as I'm about 6'2", 100 kilos plus, and nudge the jumping dog out of the way. Knock on the door and await the answer. I nearly crap myself when the guy opens the door and is about 6'8", and built like a brick house. I explain that I am the landlord's son, that I was there about the rent, and nicely explain that they just need to bring it up to date, and if they do, the letter doesn't mean anything. He then opens the letter and loses his crap, and basically tells me to get lost. Anyway, they bring rent up to date, buying themselves some time, and then stopped paying. Second time I go down with another notice, and they're gone, which wouldn't have been a bad result, but I see the state of the property, and realize these aren't just gutter trash. Dirty mattresses outside, an old couch their dog had been sleeping on, broken toys and gear outside, garbage inside and out, broken furniture inside, and one of the worst. The dog's been inside the house, torn carpet, crap stains, filth. Anyhow, they're gone, and my parents and I start the process of many weekends of work to get the place suitable for human occupation. In addition, starting the small claims court process, Dad got a summons, but it has to be served, lodging the matter with a collection agency. I'm determined to find them. He's been fired from his job, but I did find her Facebook profile, so I know it'll only be a matter of time. A week or so later, Mum spotted them in the local supermarket near home, a lead. This means that they're most likely in the local area. I spend a few hours driving around looking for their car, but to no avail. In the meantime, we're still cleaning up the property. All their crap has been dragged to the carport ready for disposal. Another week or so passes, then I hit gold. The stupid bee has posted on a public Facebook page that they're having a birthday party for their daughter at their house and their address. Not the revenge yet, but I go around to serve them the summons. Anxiety peaking, I knock on the door of the new house. The brick house opens the door to my stupid grin. It took him a moment to realize who I was. He's only seen me the once before. With a look of shock, he tries to slam the door, but not before I yell that he's being served and throw the summons inside. Now, some revenge. All of their stinking, half-wet, moldy possessions are still at Mum and Dad's rental. Dad takes a day off work and hires a tipper truck, and we set about filing it. Can you see what's coming? It took a good few hours and really filled the truck. Garbage and everything. Just on dark, we roll past their house, and happily they are home as their cars are in the narrow driveway. I open the gate on the back of the truck and remove the ropes and get back in to watch the fun. Dad starts to reverse, raising the tray as we go, timing it perfectly so as he makes the driveway, it's about to fall. We're in the driveway and he dumps it, filling the driveway, blocking the car in, covering the front yard with all of their crap. Hearing the noise, they come out running to the house screaming, but we're on our way lowering the truck as we go, so freaking happy. They're going to have fun with everyone turning up for their kid's birthday the next day, especially as it'll take them hours to move the crap, even to get their car out. Who knows what their neighbors thought? I think that's the tricky thing with tenants, is that they're people, right? And people are a mixed bag. Some of them take responsibility and are OCD about being clean, and others, well, others are like these people. They'll take as much advantage of you as possible, because they think they'll be able to get away with it. Well, not in this case. I guess they were just too stupid to not put their address publicly available for anyone to see. I'm not sure of the legality of it, but I'm assuming because it was their property that they'd left there and abandoned, on the rental property which didn't belong to them, the homeowners had the right to remove it and return it. I'm just glad they had the foresight to think, they might try and escape again. Let's block in the car. And the timing with the birthday party just means that all their friends are now forced to see what kind of people they really are. One ordinary Sunday, I was working my private lessons shift. Private lessons are more expensive than group lessons, and we as instructors get paid more for them. So only people with a reasonable amount of experience teaching swimming, usually at least 2 years, get assigned to these shifts. I'm the only person on this shift who has yet to be promoted to manager of some sort. Background: I'm a petite 18-year-old girl with a rather conservative style, no tattoos, no piercings except earlobes, mid-back length haircut and no dye. My coworker Casey is a rather large man in his early 20s with facial hair and multiple tattoos. This becomes relevant pretty quickly. A family shows up for their lessons. One of their girls is an adorable, quiet 5-year-old girl, Mia. Mia was my student months ago, but the family took a break from swimming lessons, and in the meantime, I got a new student during that time slot, so I couldn't teach her anymore. This was the family's first day back from several months of no lessons, so we had to figure out who the kids' teachers would be. I looked at the schedule and told Mia that Casey would be her teacher. I introduced her to Casey, and she followed him without any sign of disagreement or hesitation. Now, even though Casey might appear intimidating to a small child, he's actually pretty good with kids, and he definitely knows how to teach. Kids tend to make good progress with him as their instructor. I was getting in the water with my student, in a different part of the pool from where Casey was teaching Mia, when I was interrupted by none other than Mia's dad.
Excuse me?
Yes?
You really have to be more careful about who you hire for this job.
What do you mean?
I don't want a big man with tattoos teaching my little daughter. He is not a good teacher for her. She should have someone else.
I'm sorry, but I have no control over the schedule, and I certainly can't control the hiring process. If it's any consolation, Casey's a good instructor. He has lots of experience with teaching swim lessons. I'm sure he'll teach Mia well.
But still, it must be scary for her to have this instructor. Could she have a girl teacher like last time? Or a guy who isn't as scary? Like that one?
Pointing to another instructor, a super fit guy who's barely taller than I am. I understand your concern, but I have no control over the schedule. My supervisor's phone number is on the website where you registered for lessons. Contact her with any concerns. I'm sorry to cut you off, but I have to get this lesson started. Mia's lesson went smoothly, and she had no qualms about having Casey as her instructor. The end. I think it'd be a different story if the kid themselves was really intimidated or scared by the instructor. You know, eventually that's something that kids just have to get over. But if they're 5 years old, and their previous teacher was a female teacher that they really liked, you could understand why they might be scared or intimidated. But considering the kid had no problems, and the teacher was qualified, and she seemed like she enjoyed the class, this was definitely just some weird prejudice the dad had. If it was such a big concern to him, why didn't he make sure that he signed up with a particular teacher before they signed up for the class? Most of the time when you're signing up for some training, teaching, coaching, usually there's some acknowledgement of who your coach is going to be before you get started. So maybe that's slightly on the business for not letting them know beforehand, but I think it's also on the parents for not confirming beforehand as well. So a little bit of backstory. I'm a college student and have a bunch of friends that have birthdays. Wait, don't we all? And we all planned to have a party. We were split into groups of roughly 4, but there were 15 of us, so someone's group had to be 3. The food group is the group of 3, and also I was in that group. Now onto the story. Me and my friends decided to split up. Friend 1 and 2 got the starter and main course. I was very good at desserts, so I got the desserts alone. I got some packs of gummy bears to decorate the cake with. We made a huge 3-tiered cake with different kinds of sweets. I grabbed the 5-kilogram pack of sugar, and EM looks at me with a face of disappointment and anger. I look at her like, what the heck is that look for? She huffs and pulls her child by the arm. After like 10 minutes, I have just the right ingredients for the cake, and all I have to get was some sample sweets. And at the Mr. Kipling French Fancies, I grab like 2 packs of 6 French Fancies per pack, and there is none other than the EM about 7 meters away. And of course, she spots me and approaches me. The conversation went as follows.
You should be ashamed of yourself.
What?
All them sweet, you're going to be fat in no time.
This is not just for me.
Of course you were buying it for yourself. Who else could it be for?
My friends were looking at the steaks that were a few aisles away and could hear all of this. Friend 1 came over.
It's for our friend's birthday party, geez.
No, if it was for a birthday party, then they would be here too to plan their party food, you liar.
They are getting the entertainment.
Mommy, Mommy, I want some sweets too. Can you get them to get me some sweets?
EM looks at her child with a look saying, "I'm right on that, my darling." No, you will never get us to pay for your child.
You must! My little angel has been so good all week, he deserves a gift.
Friend 2 comes over with their cart. This is important later.
If he was that good, then buy it yourself.
I couldn't possibly afford that. Look at the stuff I'm already buying.
In her basket, there was wine and beer and other stuff. Not for a darn 5-year-old. Me and my friends chuckled.
What's so funny?
Me and my friends looked at each other and we knew we were thinking the same phrase. We were right.
Well, your basket is clearly stuffed for your own selfish needs.
And it doesn't look like you had any thought into your angel in any of these items.
You clearly have no care and just want some poor souls to pay for your son.
Well, you, I'm getting the manager to ban you.
Don't worry, Mommy, I'll handle this. You people are mean and rude and deserve to go to jail.
And?
I'm getting the manager.
We continue shopping and I finished the sugary bits of the food and helped my friends on the last bits of food. And when we were on our way to check out, we saw none other than the EM and EK. EK was crying, but clearly it was fake.
They are the people who hurt my darling.
Is this true?
No, she said that I got too many sweets and we tried to explain that it was for a party. She wouldn't believe us.
That's not true.
I will have to look at the camera footage.
No, you don't. They're telling lies.
This was a smart manager because he knew if EM hesitated, she would be telling lies.
You are clearly telling me lies. Ma'am, I would have to ask you to leave.
Fine, but you would all be hearing from me.
And she tries to leave with the basket without paying. But the manager stopped her. I didn't hear much because I was paying, but I think she was banned from the shop. But the most important part is that my friend had a great birthday, and I had a great time. I think it's important to remember that you'll always meet people like this in the real world. Maybe not every day, but there's always people that are going to cause you some sort of trouble. So it's important to take a moment to celebrate the good times. Things like birthday parties with your friends.
Submit your story to be read on the channel at voiceyhearstories@gmail.com and join our Voicey Veteran community at r/voiceyhear. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that bell to never miss an episode. All right, Voicey Veterans, I'll see you in the next one.